I'm sure we have, I will be sitting down next, so that we're all on the same level with the panel. We are here this afternoon to continue with the program that was run this morning, but on a different note. I'm here with many people, as you can see, with our pastor. They will all introduce themselves, right? I'm not going to introduce them. I'll give them a chance each to introduce themselves. But just the main aim and the focus of our engagement this afternoon is to stop theorizing, right? Sometimes when we talk on theory, it's sometimes difficult for some of us to really understand and take in. And today we said we want to change that. We would like to get the perspectives of those who are directly impacted and affected by, I'm not going to say what you can say by disability, but those who have different abilities, right? Those who are differently abled. And we would love to hear from them. It's going to be so interesting. Because I'm sure we're going to notice that some of us have grown into acquiring different abilities, right, that we never thought we would have to acquire. And just go to the first slide. I just want to open with the verse and the context, the biblical context. Can we move to the first slide? Yes, come. Yeah, I'm looking for it now. But is it projecting there?
Yes.
Sure. All right. So you're going up John chapter 9, verse 1 to 3, right? As he passed by, he saw a man blind from birth. And his disciples asked him, "Rabbi, who sinned, this man or his parents, that he was born blind?" There's so many things in this verse, right? Who sinned, this man or his parents? I'm sure those are the questions that we ask ourselves whenever we see people who are different from us. Right? What went wrong? Who is to blame? We are looking to assign blame on something or on someone. And it was the case with his disciples. Right? And Jesus answered and said, "It was not that this man sinned, all his parents. Nobody is to blame here. But that the works of God might be displayed in him." It's not the man, it's not his parents, but it is for the works of God to be displayed in the man. But some of us never really think it that way. Whenever we have something that is different from us, there's always that something aching and the negative feelings that come with it. Do we ever think of it as a blessing? Is there something positive that we can gain out of it? Or are we always left with the feelings of, "I wish I could change this"? Always mourning the something you never had that you wished for. And that may hinder you from moving forward and accepting the situation and making the best of it. Right? And some of us, how do we respond to that? We hide.
away, ourselves or our people, or that which we think is a deviation from the norm. Hide it away, it's a shame. That was happening in the olden days. People who are different inward, they were hidden away. Some days are open it. Some were locked up in rooms, they couldn't even see the sun. I don't know what we do today with our relatives and our people who may be directly affected. What feelings does it bring to us? And what feelings does it bring to us also in relation to our relationship with God? What does it mean for us being in that situation? So I've got my beloved panel members here, of which we are going to get their perspectives, right? Hear from them as a church now, as a collective. What is our role? What is it that we need to do? How should we respond? Do we have people who have got different abilities amongst us? If we say no, why is it the case? If there are some, where are they? Do we know what their needs are? Are we sure if we are providing for them or not? I'm going to start here. Each one